Welcome back to another episode of Hustle and Fish. Today we're going to be covering rigging on one of the most infamous baits in SoCal history, the flying fish. Hustle Fish, you don't want to miss this. Stay tuned. Let's go. Welcome back to another episode of Hustle and Fish. Now, I've been getting a lot of DMs, a lot of people asking questions how I rig my flying fish. This guy right here. Now, there's lots of ways to do it, guys. Lots of ways to do it. Lots of websites that break it down nicely. You can go to BillyKFishing.com. You can go to your saltwater guide. These are places that I went to, learned, tried it, it worked, and as time went by, put my own little twist on it. Now today I'm gonna be rigging with last year's rig. I don't know if you guys can see this, but September 14th, 2019, this rig right here brought home a 309 pound bluefin tuna. What we have here, 300 pound mono. Keep my leader not too long. What's that, about 3 feet? You guys can see that. That's the stinger right there. That's a 4X strong, made by owner. The size is 4-0. Got the circle, also made by owner. That's a 7-0 circle. Like I said, the distance I use is one hand. It's very important, guys. I've done them too short, I've done them too long, and this is my go-to. You want the hooks naturally to be parallel with the flying fish. Now, this is an old one from a trip. Typically, the wings are looking super nice. They're looking like this on a fresh bait. This wing is looking like this. So, what I was doing was putting my 7-0 circle Mutu right above this first wing right here, guys. So what was happening, if I wasn't getting bit within the first hour, this meat was getting loose. I decided I was gonna rig something different, but I'm gonna show you a way to rig it where the bait's gonna last and you'll get the best bang for your flying fish. And that's what we're here to do here at Hustle and Fish. So the way I'm gonna show you guys today is with chopsticks. That's right, chopsticks. I haven't heard of no one using chopsticks. Right on top of that wing, something like this right here. So, this is the starting point right here, guys. So what we use here is zip ties, guys. Go to Home Depot. Buy the smallest zip ties they sell, these guys right here. Keep your hand on the zip tie because it will destroy the wing if you're not careful. So, on the bottom, that's what it looks like. These bluefin actually prefer chopsticks. You know, it looks a little more nicer. You got a fresh bait. But I've been hit with sloppy seconds like this. Sloppy seconds, I've been hammered. So, just wanna give you a good visual. That's what we're talking about. Oh, kinda like that. I do not put the hook in the meat no more. Doesn't last, it don't have the longevity. If you get bit quick, you're good, but if you don't. So what I use now, it's a little spectral. So what you want to grab is your rigging needle, and you're going to support the hook to the chopstick. What you do now is just simple overhand knot, maybe a couple of them. So it's nice and tight. The stinger, right in the back where this last fin is at. drop that in. And there you have it. That's how it should be looking. When it's in the water, hitting that wave, it's just looking sexy, sexy as can be. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, share, and we'll see you on the next one. Hustle and fish. Peace.